are those theorized by Margaret Kennedy. She explains what are the consequences of an interest-based economy.
Most people think they pay interest only when they borrow money in the bank. And in fact, it is quite obvious that every producer of a good has to put the interest that he pays to the bank into the price. If you look at everything you need, if people need to live, it's about 45% interest they pay for on average.
According to Margaret Kennedy's researches, the hidden interest on what we spend for our living is roughly 45%.
If you look at who profits from these interest payments and who pays, you can see, and you subdivide the German population in 10 equal parts, you can see that 80% of the people pay more interest in the prices. That those are the people who work for their money. And with 10% in Germany, it's about the same. They pay as much interest as they get from interest payments from their life insurances, savings, etc. And the last 10% get all that added on to their income from interest, which the first 80% lose.
Let's split Germany's population in 10 equal parts using a scale of increasing wealth. The gray area is the interest paid in all prices, and the area is the interest earned from monetary and real assets. According to Margaret Kennedy's calculation, the 80% of worst-off German population loses more. Position 1 to 8, the interest paid is more than what they earn. 10% of population, on position 9, gets the same money they spend. The remaining 10% gets all that interest which the former 80% lose.
So we have a constant redistribution mechanism in our money system. From 80% of the people who work for their money, they pay, to 10% of the people who can make their money work for them. And you have to own about over 500,000 euros in order to begin to profit from the system.